Diwali is a day when we celebrate by bursting crackers and lighting diyas for the win of good over evil. There are many stories as to why we celebrate Diwali. The most famous of them is the story of Narakasura. Why do we celebrate a day for an asura? What makes him so special to be celebrated over all asuras? In today's video, we will share an interesting story about Narakasura and how Diwali is associated with this demon. So watch till the end. The story of Narakasura goes back in time to Dwapara Yuga. The Asura was the son of Bhudevi and Lord Vishnu's Varaha avatar. Narakasura once did a deep penance to please Lord Brahma. When Lord Brahma appeared in front of him, he desired a boon where he could only be killed by his mother, Bhudevi. Lord Brahma looked at his devotee and said, "Tadhastu." The tyrant demon terrorized the people of the earth and even wanted to conquer the heaven with his powers. The demon king held 16,000 princesses of the defeated kingdoms and imprisoned them. After he defeated everyone on the earth, Narakasura, with his mace, knocked on the door of Indradev in heaven. Fearing Narakasura's wrath, the king of gods ran away. This in turn allowed Narakasura to capture the apsaras of heaven, including Indradev's mother Aditi. Indradev, with his folded hands, went to Vaikuntha to seek Lord Vishnu's help. Guess what Lord Vishnu did? Lord Vishnu consoled Indradev and told him that for every problem there is a solution. Lord Vishnu told Indradev that his avatar of Lord Krishna with his wife Satyabhama were the answer to the evil tyrant Narakasura. To Indradev's surprise, Satyabhama was an incarnation of Bhudevi. Indradev went to seek Lord Krishna's help. Lord Krishna was playing his melody on the flute to his wife Satyabhama and sensed Indradev's presence and paused. Indradev, with his folded hands, pleaded Satyabhama and Lord Krishna and told them the deeds of Narakasura. Satyabhama was furious with what the demon king did to Indradev's mother Aditi and 16,000 other princesses. Do you know what Satyabhama did with the rage she had? Satyabhama, along with Lord Krishna, mounted on Garuda to wage a battle against the demon Narakasura. On the battlefield, Narakasura was ready with his army. Lord Krishna fought the entire army and started to fight Narakasura. But Narakasura attacked Lord Krishna in such a way that Lord Krishna became unconscious for a while. Satyabhama became more furious seeing her husband faint. She pulled her arrow out of the quiver and stretched it on her bow. And with one shot of her arrow, she injured Narakasura badly. Now here is the big twist. Moments before Narakasura's death, Lord Krishna conveyed to Satyabhama that Narakasura was her son. Looking at Satyabhama, Narakasura asked for a wish from his mother. He wished that he be remembered for joy and not for the hate he spread. Satyabhama blessed his child with a boon and that day came to be known as Naraka Chaturdashi. This day is celebrated the day before Diwali in the remembrance of Narakasura. But the story isn't over yet. Lord Krishna is said to have married the 16,000 princesses that were imprisoned by Narakasura. Later, Lord Krishna streaked his forehead with the blood of Narakasura. His wives washed the blood off him and anointed him with perfume oils and gave him an elaborate bath. And to this day, it has become a ritual during the time of dawn on Naraka Chaturdashi. Naraka Chaturdashi is widely celebrated for the equality of genders, where both Satyabhama and Lord Krishna equally fought against the evil to win the war. So, on the eve of Diwali, a festival of such kind is celebrated where the women have an elaborate bath and light diyas in the evening for the remembrance of Narakasura. In North India, this day is usually referred to as Choti Diwali. Hope you like this interesting story as to why Diwali is celebrated. Share this interesting tale with your friends and family. See you in the next video with another tale from our Puranas. Until then, happy Diwali.